வணக்கம், வெல்கம் பேக் டு அவர் கோர்ஸ் ஆன் எஸ்ஏபி ப்ரொடக்ஷன் பிளானிங். சாரி ஃபார் த டிலே இன் பப்ளிஷிங் திஸ் செஷன். இந்த லாஸ்ட் செஷன் வி டிஸ்கஸ் அபவுட் மாஸ்டர் டேட்டா ரிக்வயர்ட் டு இன்ஸ்டால் எஸ்ஏபி ப்ரொடக்ஷன் பிளானிங் ப்ராசஸஸ் சக்ஸஸ்ஃபுல்லி இன் யுவர் ஆர்கனைசேஷன். இட் வாஸ் இன்சிஸ்டட் தட் மெயின்டைனிங் ப்ராப்பர் மாஸ்டர் டேட்டா இஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அண்ட் கிரிட்டிக்கல். இன் திஸ் செஷன் வி வில் டிஸ்கஸ் overview of material master. From next session onwards, I will take you through all critical material master parameters required for SAP production planning along with their processes and impacts. So it will not be just parameters discussion, but it will be a complete discussion about the functionalities of those parameters in SAP. Okay, now let us review the answers for self-assessment 3 shared in the last session. Which are the basic master data for SAP production planning? Those are material master, bill of material, work center or a resource, and then routing or a master recipe and production version. What is the sequence of creating basic master data for SAP PP? First you have to create material master, based on which you have to create bill of material, then the work center has to be created, and then routing has to be created combining this bill of material and work centers with the standard time and other details, and the production version has to be created linking the routing and bill of material. And then which are the views which are organization independent? These are all basic data view, classification views, some fields in sales views, and also plant and store location views. Which are the important views for SAP PP? Okay, all the views are important, they are all interlinked, but specific to PP, which are all the fields? MRP views, there are 4 views: work scheduling view, production planning and detailed scheduling, the PPDS, that is one thing, and then forecasting. What are the functions of bill of materials? Material planning, work scheduling, procurement and product costing. And then what are the examples of work centers? It may be an individual machine, it may be a production line, it's maybe an individual or group of people, and then manufacturing cell. Anything may be a work center. And then what is routing? Routing is sequence of operations to produce a product. It contains what is the work center to be produced, what is the standard time required, what are the components to be used, then what is the production resource tools, documents attached, etc. What are the details copied from work center to routing? I mean, there are some details when we create any master data of routing, some details will be carried out, these are carried from work center to routing, like default values, standard value key, then how to control the standard value, which is the standard value control, activity types like a labor, a machine or setup, those kind of things, and then the formula to calculate capacity or scheduling or costing. Then what is the default allocation of components to routing? Whenever the BOM is attached to the routing, so there is automatically there are some components which is attached. The default attachment is with operation 0010, but later we can change. Some components may be assigned to operation 20, some operation may be assigned to 20, but 30, but the default, when you attach them, it will be attached to the operation 10, which is the first operation. What is the purpose of production version? It is a combination of BOM and routing. If a product has more than one way to produce a product, whether there is a change in BOM or work center or routing, production version can be used to differentiate the production method. That is the purpose. Okay. Right. Now, let us review the discussions we had in the course so far. We started with the production planning in business process. Key elements in SAP production planning like master data, sales and operations, material requirement planning, long-term planning, etc. Then we saw overview of SAP PP process through a flowchart and understood the process and also some key terminologies. Then we discussed in detail on 3 types of production and importance of selection of the production type, and then characteristics and examples of those production types. After this, we discuss the organization elements of SAP PP and how they are aligned with the physical organization structure and functions. The discussions included company core, plant, factory calendar, and store location with the definition, configuration steps, and their importance in successful implementation of SAP PP. In the last session, we discussed about the basic master data required for PP, like a metal master, bill of material, work centers, routing, and production version. And in this session, we are going to discuss about material master, like how to create the metal master, and a brief introduction of various views in metal master. A material is anything used in producing a product or service. It may be part of the product or service, or it may be supporting materials. Examples of the products or services are like a raw material, which is converted into components, then semi-finished goods, which are produced from the components, and the finished products, which are produced from semi-finished goods and maybe with some components. And to produce these things, we need to have some supporting materials, which are called like consumables, like a grease, lubricant oil, gloves, etc. And then the production resource tools, like tools, fixers, and the jigsaws, whatever things are required to support the production. And the spares required for maintenance of the machines. And then packaging materials to complete the production by packing them properly to secure the material and also prepare it for transportation. The metal master represents the central source of releasing the metal specific data. It is used by all the logistics components like ordering and purchasing, updating the metal movement of goods and managing the physical inventory in inventory management, posting the invoices in invoice verification, processing sale orders in sales, planning requirements, scheduling and work in production planning and control. As the metal master is a central element, creating and maintaining information on metal master is the collective and a combined responsibility of a company's various departments and divisions. In SAP system, maintaining a proper structured information, it will help to relevant department to perform their operations efficiently and effectively on day-to-day basis. And to add greater visibility to the entire metal master creation, in SAP, the metal master is arranged in the views like, you know, MRP view, purchasing view, production view, like that, in which the relevant departments of the company will create the details based on their functional need, which will be sharing the information. Each ISO department has its own view of metal master record. As I told, the accounting department, they will be storing the accounting details in the accounting view. And the metal planning team, they will be storing the details in the MRP view. Sales team will update the details in the sales view. Also, we discussed in the earlier sessions that the views are organization independent and some are having the parameters in the view which are the organization dependent. There are some details which are like a mix of organization dependent and organization independent. It's mixed. For example, a basic and classification views, or the organization dependence. Basic and classification views are organization independent views. And then MRP, purchasing, accounting, costing views are the organization dependent. Some parameters in sales organization view, plant storage views are organization independent, though the views are organization independent. Please note that at least one plan specific view like MRP view or work scheduling view must be maintained for the material as well as the accounting and the costing views. Now let us discuss how to create the metal master in SAP. In general, to create the metal master, the menu path what is shown here is used, or the transaction which is MM01. So here first enter the metal code. And it is assigned to the industry sector and metal type. Industry sector determines what is the screen sequence and the field selection in metal master and defines to hide or open the fields. When you are creating the metal master, which field has to be open, which field has to be hidden, those things will be there. And also which field has to be made mandatory, which has to be made optional. Those things can be covered through this industry sector. And also please note that metal is assigned to an industry sector. It cannot be changed. So it has to be carefully assigned. And the metal type is responsible for external and internal number assignment, because the metal master, we can define the materials by externally by giving by us, or we can also allow the system to create its own metal master, main number. And also determine which views are available and in which sequence, and how the metal has to be configured. And metal type helps to control the inventory management requirement, as well as accounts of goods movements, like updating the quantity and value in the when you're doing the transactions, or like purchasing or putting into inventory. There are some other ways to create metal master. Earlier we discussed about MM01. A new metal master can be created by copying from other metal also. Now, there is a metal raw material is there already there. If you want to create another raw material, we can refer that raw material, then create this. It is like a copy function. So, but at the same time, we have to be very careful that we are selecting the right material where we copy from. And also we can create the material with a schedule. It is similar to the MM01 where we have to create it immediately. But here using MM11, the same function will do it, but we will specify what is the date and time that metal has to be created. So accordingly it will be created. So we can schedule that when the metal has to be created in system. And metal can be created for specific metal type also, which is given in this S4HANA, right? And also earlier also it was there in the recent versions. For example, that when I create a metal master for raw materials, the T code MMR1 which is used. Similarly, if you want to create a semi-finished good like a HALB, then the T code MMB1 will be used. That there are other transactions which are required to create the materials, different type of materials. What are the transactions? The list is given here. So it will be easy, right, to which are the views to be created, which are default as a standard given by the SAP itself. So we don't want to create specific views or something, so we can follow the standard, which will be easy to create. While creating a fresh metal code, after entering the metal code, industry sector metal type, press enter. And while creating the metal, system may provide all the views, right? As we see here, it will provide all the views. But we may not be interested in to maintain all the views. So we can select the views and save them with using that default setting button, right? So by clicking this default setting, next time when we open this, all these views will be only selected. It will not show all the views here like that, then we need to select, those things will not be there. Similarly, to reduce our, we can also define what is the organization we need, like plant details or store location details. Those kind of details also we can enter and save it. So whenever we create a material or whenever we display the materials, these views and also the organization details are default, it will appear. And if you want to change, you can change and proceed further, but it will reduce the workload of seeing the metal master details using this function. Let us go through some of the key details available in various views of metal master. As I told, from next session we'll go through the critical parameters in detail, along with their functions and also application of the business process. Now here we see the basic data. Basic data views consist of information such as basic unit of measure, which is the smallest unit of measure in which you maintain the product's inventory. This view consists of gross weight, net weight, volume, product hierarchy, size, dimension, design, drawing details, etc. Then classification view, which enables to classify specific materials with similar characteristics into groups and to categorize those groups based on specific characteristics. Due to its diverse and practical nature of application, it is applied in several areas of SAP. And then sales views, it contains all the details such as like what is the delivering plant, what is the selling unit of measure, what are the taxes, conditions, transportation group, loading group, item category, those things are all there, right? So those things can be maintained in sales view. And this view has to be maintained for the metal which has to be sold, okay? So it's like a finished good or trading goods, we need to maintain it. And then purchasing view, it contains the purchase unit of measure, purchase group, metal group that groups together the metal with similar attributes. And then purchasing value key that put what is under delivery, over delivery tolerance, remainder times, GR processing time, then batch time, and also this view is important for, again, as the name of the view says, it is for all the procured, externally procured items, this view has to be maintained. And then MRP views, they enable the planners to define how to procure the material and how to plan and control this material in the production process. Here, the definition of procurement type, whether it is externally procured or internally procured, and then what is it, or whether it has to be done, can be in both the scenarios. Some materials may be produced in-house, something may be produced, the same material may be procured outside also. The, both the types also we can enable in the system. And also to specify what is the reorder point it has to be given, or it is a demand driven, and also what is the large size, what is the safety stock, what is the strategy to be followed, like make to stock or make to order, assemble to order, and all these things can be maintained in the MRP view. And then there is a production planning and detailed scheduling, in which the SAP S/4HANA is introduced as advanced capacity planning, and also heuristics for capacity planning. That was earlier available in SAP's Advanced Planning and Optimization, APO. You know, it was there earlier. So here, we can directly execute this PPDS transaction S/4HANA itself without APO. Okay. And then forecast views. This view enables to define what is the forecast parameter to be used, what is the model to be selected, like which is a constant model, seasonal model, moving average trend. And also, if you know what is the forecast set of properties, we can also select one of the models which is already available there. And the system also has the option of automatic model selection. I mean, based on the details what is provided there, system itself will suggest what is automatically, what is the model to be followed. And also we can inform to the system that how much period of historical data to be considered, and to project how much period that the forecast has to be provided. Those things we can enter there. Also, please note that when we calculate the automatic reorder point, this forecast view will be useful to calculate the reorder point automatically by the system, and also based on service level, safety stock also can be created using this forecasting view. These things we will see when we are discussing individual parameters later. Then work scheduling. This view contains the details under the, like what is under delivery, over delivery tolerance for the in-house production, what is the production unit of measurement, and what is the, who is the production scheduler, what is the production scheduling profile, all those things will be there. And for any in-house production item, this view must be maintained. So whenever we want to create any production order or planned order is not created, we need to check whether the work scheduling view is there or not. And then plant or store location view. This view contains information such as storage bin, temperature conditions, shelf life data for batch manager items, including maximum and storage period, what is the remaining shelf life, all those things we can see. And then quality management view, it provides the option to select different inspection types. There may be different type of inspections, different frequencies, different parameters may be there. So those kind of inspection types can be selected. And if it is for finished good, there may be one kind of inspection. For raw material, there may be kind of inspection. For work in process, there may be another inspection. All those things we can be creating it. And also the quality procurement key, it informs that raw material must be procured as a quality managed. And also what is the relevant certification type, those things can be managed. In accounting view, we maintain what is the price control indicator, whether it is standard price or the moving average price, and also what is the valuation class, those kind of details we can maintain. In costing view, we maintain this variance key, what are the costing details, so we can go through the costing details, like drill down, what are the details like metal cost, overheads cost, we can see. And also what is the origin group, where it is originated, the cost, those details we can see. So in this session, so far we discussed what is the overview of different types of materials, how to create the metal master, and some overview of individual views in the metal master, so that we can have a broad understanding of what is a metal master. And now it is time for self-assessment. Here we have these 10 questions, which means you can just go through them. Prepare yourself, so answers will be shared in the next session. So as I told, from the next session onwards, we will go through the individual parameters with from different views in Metal Master, which are relevant for production planning. And we will discuss the detailed functions, so that later when you go for the detailed discussion, for example, MRP planning. So we need not wait for that, we go for the MRP planning discussion. In the, during Metal Master discussion itself, what is the parameter? For example, MRP type means, I will be discussing what are all the different types of MRP types, other things. So that the participants or the trainers, you can link that field with the function immediately. That is how I will approach the subsequent sessions. Please go through these sessions and give your feedback as usual, and give your comments while subscribing to our channel. Meanwhile, please visit our website www.vgrovin.com to know about our services, not only in SAP but also in supply chain and soft skills. Thank you for your time, and see you in the next session.